गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 45 ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, यूनिट 5, इज अ फ्यूल एंड कंबशन। इन दिस यूनिट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टाइप ऑफ फ्यूल, अप्रॉक्सिमेट एंड अल्टीमेट एनालिसिस ऑफ फ्यूल, कंबशन थ्योरी, कंबशन इक्वेशन, थ्योरेटिकल एंड एक्सेस एयर रिक्वायरमेंट, इक्विवेलेंस रेशियो, एनालिसिस ऑफ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ कंबशन, कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू दैट इज हायर कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू एंड लोअर कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू, बॉम एंड बॉयज गैस कैलोरीमीटर, फ्लू गैस एनालिसिस यूजिंग ऑरसेट ऑपरेटर्स, एग्जॉस्ट गैस एनालाइजर, एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन एंड एडियाबेटिक फ्लेम टेम्परेचर, एडियाबेटिक फ्लेम टेम्परेचर। नाउ इन इंट्रोडक्शन वी विल सी द बेसिक इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द फ्यूल। यू माइट हैव स्टडीड फ्यूल इन केमिस्ट्री इन 12th स्टैंडर्ड, द मोस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट इज सिमिलर, बट स्लाइटली विल सी द न्यू सम फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंथैल्पी एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्यूल विच आर नॉट बीन कवर्ड इन द 12th स्टैंडर्ड। ओके, नाउ फ्यूल्स आर ऑफ मेनली टू टाइप्स, दैट इज केमिकल फ्यूल एंड न्यूक्लियर फ्यूल, बट ब्रॉडली वी विल सी केमिकल फ्यूल इन दिस यूनिट। Will not discuss nuclear fuel in this unit. Broadly, we'll discuss about the chemical fuel. Now, chemical fuels are divided into three types according to their physical structure. That is, liquid fuel, gaseous fuel, and solid fuel. Okay. Here we shall consider briefly chemical fuels only. Now, chemical fuel is a substance which releases heat energy on the combustion. When the chemical fuel is undergo burning, it releases heat. Or when the chemical fuel undergoes chemical reaction, releases heat energy. The principal combustible element of each fuel are carbon and hydrogen. The main constituent of chemical fuel is a carbon and hydrogen. It is also called as hydrocarbon fuel. Just like petrol, petrol is hydrocarbon, diesel is hydrocarbon. Okay, if we talk about the coal, in coal there is a carbon and moisture, this hydrogen percent is there. If we talk about kerosene, it is a hydrocarbon. If we talk about any fuel, it is a hydrocarbon, consists of hydrogen and carbon mostly. Though sulfur is a combustible element too, but its presence in the fuel is undesirable or is considered to be undesirable. Why? Even though sulfur is a combustible and it can produce heat, but its presence in any fuel is undesirable. Even though when we were filling the petrol in our vehicle in older days, it consists of a sulfur. Nowadays petrol is a sulfur free. Why we want fuel to be a sulfur free? Because when the sulfur is burnt in presence of oxygen, it convert into sulfur dioxide, and sulfur dioxide when combines with the moisture or a water, it becomes sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. Or when the sulfur dioxide gas released in the atmosphere and combined with a cloud, and it falls as a sulfuric acid, that is acid rain. Therefore the presence of sulfur is very dangerous and it is to be removed if it is present in the fuel. Now the chemical thermodynamics, the study of system involving chemical reaction is an important topic. In case of chemical thermodynamics, we talk about the chemical reaction taking place in the system. The chemical reaction may be defined as the arrangement of atoms due to redistribution of electron. When the chemical reaction takes place, the atoms or the molecule rearranged. In the chemical reaction, the term reactant and the product are the frequently used. Whenever chemical reaction takes place, reactant combined with each other and it forms a product. Let us consider an example of carbon combines with oxygen. When carbon combines with oxygen, forms carbon dioxide. In this case, carbon and oxygen are the reactant and product is carbon dioxide. Okay. suppose hydrogen and oxygen combines and form water, that is H2O. Then hydrogen and oxygen are the reactants because they are reacting with each other. Therefore, reactant are the atoms which are combining together, and the product is a compound which is formed. Okay, end product or the end result of the chemical reaction is a product. Along with a product, we get some form of heat also, but that we do not consider in most of the cases. Reactants comprises of initial constituent which starts the reaction, while product comprises of final constituent which are formed by the chemical reaction. Okay, reactant comprises the initial constituent. That is, if we talk about the carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen are the initial constituent. Therefore, these are reactants. And final product is carbon dioxide. Therefore, it is a product. Although the basic principle which will be discussed in the chapter apply to any chemical reaction, here main attention will be focused on the important type of a chemical reaction, combustion. Okay, we'll see various chemical reaction and the combustion reaction in this chapter. Now, classification of fail. Mainly fails are classified as primary fail and the secondary fail. Before, we have seen two categories of fail, that is chemical fail and nuclear fail, but broadly in this unit we'll talk about the chemical fail only. Now, chemical fails are categorized in two categories as primary fail and secondary fail. Now, what is primary fail and secondary fail? The primary fail is the fail which is obtained naturally in that form. The primary fail is a fail which is obtained naturally in that a particular form. It's called a primary fail. Now, what is secondary fail? Secondary fail is a derived from the primary fail. Secondary fail is a derived from the primary fail. Okay. In the earth crust, we get crude oil, and that crude oil is a primary fail. Crude oil is a primary fail. From that crude oil, we separate kerosene, petrol, diesel, and various fuel. These are the secondary oils. Okay. Now, wood we obtain from the trees. Wood is a primary fuel. Now, from wood, we get different types of coals and different types of fuels. These are the secondary. Wood is a primary, and other which are getting from the wood, that is coal, different types of coal are the secondary. Now, in the gas, natural gas is a primary fuel, and from the natural gas we separate different types of gases. These are the secondary fuels. Okay. Chemical fuels are divided into three types, that is solid, liquid and gases, on the basis of their state. The detailed classification of fuel can be given in summary from the summary from as follows. We'll see the different types of fuel, that is solid fuel, liquid fuel and gaseous fuel. We'll see primary and secondary fuels of solid, liquid and gases. Look at the solid fuels first. Wood, peat and lignite coal are the primary fuels. Okay, wood, peat and lignite coal are the primary fuel. Now, coke, charcoal and briquette, these are the prepared fuel. Therefore, these prepared fuels are called as a secondary fuel. Primary fuel means the fuel which is obtained naturally in its original form. The fuel which is obtained naturally in its original form is called as a primary fuel. And the secondary fuel are the fuel which is prepared, from the with the help of primary fuel, is called as a secondary fuel. Now, liquid petroleum product. If you talk about the crude oil is a petroleum oil, petroleum fuel which is obtained from the earth crust by the degradation of aquatic animals and aquatic plants, and the fermentation of aquatic animal and plants, we get crude oil in the earth crust, and that is separated, and the different oils are separated from the crude oil, like gasoline, kerosene. Gasoline means a petrol, kerosene, fuel oil, alcohol, benzol, shale oil. These are the prepared oil from the crude oil. Therefore, these oils are called as a secondary oil. Then gases fail. Natural gas is a primary gas which is obtained in its original form, and from the natural gas we separate different gases like petroleum gas, producer gas, coal gas, coke oven gas, blast furnace gas, carbureted gas, sewer gas. These are not necessary that these all gases are obtained from the natural gas. Natural gas mostly consists of methane and ethane. Natural gas mostly consists of methane and ethane, but these gas, petroleum gas, are obtained from petroleum product, producer gas are obtained from the coal, okay, by the burning of a coal, then coal gas is obtained from the again burning of a coal, then coke oven gas is obtained from the burning of coke, then gas which is obtained from blast furnace is called as a furnace gas, then carbureted gas and sewer gas. Sewer gas is obtained from the degradation of the sewer material, okay. Solid fuel. In solid fuel, we have seen coal, peat and lignite. Okay, we have seen coal, peat and lignite coal. Its main constituent are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, moisture and ash. Coal passes through different stages during the during its formation from vegetation. These stages are discussed below. Coal is obtained from the plant debris. Okay, first plant debris are there, then plant debris convert into peat, then peat to lignite, then brown coal, then sub-bituminous coal, then bituminous coal, semi-bituminous coal, semi-anthracite coal, then anthracite coal to graphite. This is the process of formation of plant debris to graphite. Okay, plant debris undergoes various transformation and we get finally graphite. Now peat, it is the first stage of a formation of a coal from wood. Okay, peat is also obtained from wood, but this is a first stage of a coal formation by the wood. It contains huge amount of moisture and therefore it is dried for about 1 to 2 months before it is put to use. It is used as a domestic fuel in Europe and for power generation in Russia. In India, it does not come in the categories of a good fuel. In India, we mostly use the categories which is greater than or which is pure than the lignite. We mostly use anthracite in India because anthracite is considered as a good coal for the power generation as it contains least amount of ash. Then lignite and brown coal. These are intermediate stage between the peat and coal. It is an intermediate stage between peat and coal. First, they have a woody or often a clay-like appearance associated with high moisture, high ash and low heat content. In lignite, since its calorific value is very less, it contains high moisture, it contains high ash content. Therefore, in India, we do not use lignite as a fuel for power generation, specifically for power generation. But for domestic use, people use this fuel. Lignites are usually amorphous in character and impose transport difficulties as they break easily. They burn with a smoky flame. Some of the type are suitable for local use only. Therefore, lignite coal is used domestically in a village areas, but it does not use for power generation and because transportation is very difficult. During transformation, it breaks and because of the transportation, it breaks and loss of lignite coal can happen. Therefore, we do not use in a power generation. Now, bituminous coal, it burn with a long yellow and smoky flame and has a high percentage of volatile matter. The average calorific value of the bituminous coal is about 31,350 kJ/kg. This is a good fuel. This fuel can be used for the power generation if anthracite fuel is not available, okay, because it has a good calorific value. Above 30,000 above 30,000 kilojoule per kg is considered as a good calorific value, and heat generation is completely depend on the calorific value. It may be of two types, namely caking or non-caking. Now, what is mean by caking and non-caking? Non-caking means after burning of the fuel. Non-caking means after burning of a fuel, it doesn't give any residue. Caking fuel is a one. After burning of caking fuel, it gives a residue. Like when we burn the coal, it gives ash, and ash is considered as residue. But condition is that the combustion or the burning should takes place in absence of air only. In absence of air, okay. If the in absence of air, if the caking coal is burnt, it gives residue. If non-caking coal is burnt, it doesn't give any residue. Semi-bituminous coal, it is softer than the anthracite. It is softer than anthracite. Anthracite is a base quality of coal. It burns with a very small amount of smoke. It burns with very small amount of smoke. It contains 15 to 20% of volatile matter and has a tendency to break into small size during storage or transportation. Now, semi-anthracite, it has less fixed carbon and a less luster as compared to true anthracite, and gives out longer and more lustrous flame when burnt. It is also good quality of fuel, can be used in the power plant for power generation. Anthracite, it is very hard coal and has a shining black luster. It ignites slowly unless the furnace temperature is high. Means it doesn't give a much flame, but it gives very high temperature when it burns. It is a non-caking and has high percentage of fixed carbon. It has high percentage of fixed carbon and very less percentage of ash. Therefore, it comes in the category of non-caking. It burns either with very short blue flame or without flame. It burns with either very short blue flame, very short blue flame, or without flame. But it gives very high. It can give very high temperature. It burns at very high temperature. Therefore, the calorific value of this fuel is very high, and the tune of 35,500 kilojoule per kg. And as such, is very suitable for steam generation. Has very suitable for power generation in the power plant. Now, wood charcoal. Wood charcoal is a charcoal obtained by the destructive distillation of the wood. Now, what is meant by destructive distillation? It is obtained by destructive distillation of wood. During the process, the volatile matter and the waste water are expelled. The physical properties of the residual, that is charcoal, however, depends upon the rate of heating and temperature. Now, this old charcoal is obtained by destructive distillation. Now, what is destructive distillation? Destructive distillation of wood means heating of wood at very high temperature. Heating of wood at very high temperature. After heating the wood, we get charcoal. Okay. Now, what is the purpose of destructive distillation? To remove the moisture content from the charcoal. Coke. It consists of a carbon mineral matter with about 2% sulfur and small quantity of hydrogen, nitrogen and phosphorus. It is a solid residue left after the destructive distillation of certain kind of a coal. It is smokeless and clear fuel and can be produced by several processes. It is mostly used in blast furnace to produce heat and at the same time to reduce the iron core. This coke is obtained by the burning of coal. When the coal is burnt and the burning of or the heating of coal is called as a destructive distillation, and this coke is obtained by destructive distillation of the coal. Means when the coal is heated or burnt at very high temperature, we get coke. When the coke is burnt, it gives very less amount of smoke. Now, briquette. These are prepared from fine coal or coke बाय कॉम्प्रेसिंग द मटेरियल अंडर हाई प्रेशर. व्हेन द पाउडर फॉर्म ऑफ अ कोल और कोक इज प्रेस्ड वी गेट ब्रिकेट्स, वी गेट ब्रिक्स और सम ब्लॉक्स, लॉग्स ऑफ कोल, एंड दैट लॉग और द ब्रिक्स ऑफ द कोल इज कॉल्ड एज अ ब्रिकेट्स. नाउ लिक्विड फ्यूल, द मेन सोर्स ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज अ पेट्रोलियम विच इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द अर्थ क्रस्ट. ओके, द मेन सोर्स ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज अ पेट्रोलियम, एंड पेट्रोलियम इज अ क्रूड ऑयल विच इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द अर्थ क्रस्ट और फ्रॉम द सी क्रस्ट. दिस फ्यूल हैव प्रूव्ड मोर एडवांटेजेस इन कंपेरिजन विद अ सॉलिड फ्यूल इन द फॉलोइंग रिस्पेक्ट. रिक्वायर्स लेस स्पेस फॉर स्टोरेज. व्हाई लेस स्पेस फॉर स्टोरेज? बिकॉज सॉलिड फ्यूल कंटेन्स मॉइस्चर. सॉलिड फ्यूल्स कैन बी अ पोरस, देयरफॉर डेंसिटी ऑफ सॉलिड फ्यूल इज अ वेरी 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 लेस एंड रिक्वायर्स लार्ज स्पेस फॉर द स्टोरेज. द डेंसिटी ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज अ वेरी हाई. डेंसिटी ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज अ वेरी हाई. इट इज नॉन कॉम्प्रेसिबल सिंस इट इज अ लिक्विड, देयरफॉर रिक्वायर्स लेस स्पेस टू स्टोर हाई कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू. द कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ सॉलिड फ्यूल इज लेस देन लिक्विड फ्यूल, देयरफॉर इन ऑटोमोबाइल वी प्रिफर लिक्विड फ्यूल बिकॉज लिक्विड फ्यूल हैज अ हाई कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू. इजी कंट्रोल ऑफ कंजप्शन. वी कैन कंट्रोल द कंजप्शन ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल. हाई इकोनॉमी सिंस द कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज हाई, इट गिव्स हाई इकोनॉमी. अब्सेंस ऑफ डेंजर फ्रॉम स्पॉन्टेनियस कंबशन. इन सॉलिड फ्यूल टू स्टोर वी रिक्वायर्ड लार्ज स्पेस एंड वी कैन नॉट पास द सॉलिड फ्यूल फ्रॉम द वेरी नैरो पैसेज, देयरफॉर स्टोरेज रिक्वायर्ड वेरी लार्ज स्पेस एंड देर इज अ चांसेस ऑफ कंबशन और स्पॉन्टेनियस कंबशन. बट वी कैन पास लिक्विड फ्यूल फ्रॉम नोजल, फ्रॉम पाइप, देयरफॉर द चांसेस ऑफ डेंजर और चांसेस ऑफ कंबशन, स्पॉन्टेनियस कंबशन इज वेरी लेस इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल. इजी हैंडलिंग एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. इजी हैंडलिंग एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सिंस लिक्विड फ्यूल इज हाईली डेंस, इट रिक्वायर्स लेस स्पेस फॉर द स्टोरेज, देयरफॉर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड हैंडलिंग इज वेरी इजी. क्लीनिनेस आफ्टर द बर्निंग ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज डजेंट प्रोड्यूस एनी स्मोक. इट डजेंट प्रोड्यूस एनी स्मोक एंड इट इज फ्री फ्रॉम ऐश, देयरफॉर द क्लीनिनेस ऑफ लिक्विड फ्यूल इज हाई. नो ऐश प्रॉब्लम. लिक्विड फ्यूल डजेंट कंटेन एनी ऐश एज दैट ऑफ कोल एंड ऑल. नो डिटोरिएशन ऑफ द लिक्विड इन द स्टोरेज. मीन्स लिक्विड फ्यूल डजेंट डिटोरिएट. लिक्विड फ्यूल प्रिवेंट इट्स प्रॉपर्टी व्हेन इट इज स्टोर्ड फ्रॉम फॉर लॉन्गर टाइम. बट व्हेन द सॉलिड फ्यूल इज स्टोर्ड फ्रॉम फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम इट डिटोरिएट्स. इट चेंजेस द प्रॉपर्टी. इट एब्जॉर्ब द मॉइस्चर एंड डिक्रीज द हीट कंटेंट. पेट्रोलियम. दीज आर डिफरेंट ओपिनियन. देर आर डिफरेंट ओपिनियन रिगार्डिंग द ओरिजिन ऑफ अ पेट्रोलियम. ओके, हाउ एवर नाउ इट इज एक्सेप्टेड दैट पेट्रोलियम हैज ओरिजिनेटेड प्रोबेबली फ्रॉम द ऑर्गेनिक मैटर लाइक फिश एंड प्लांट लाइफ एटसेट्रा बाय बैक्टेरिया एक्शन और बाय देयर डिस्टिलेशन अंडर प्रेशर एंड हीट. मीन्स वॉट इज द सोर्स ऑफ पेट्रोलियम इज नॉट क्लियर, बट इट इज बीन एक्सेप्टेड दैट इट इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द एक्वेटिक एनिमल एंड एक्वेटिक प्लांट्स इन द सी क्रस्ट बाय द बैक्टेरियल एक्शन एंड और बाय डिस्टिलेशन अंडर प्रेशर एंड हीट. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस, लिक्विड एंड सॉलिड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स विद अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ नाइट्रोजन एंड सल्फर कंपाउंड. इन इंडिया द मेन सोर्स ऑफ पेट्रोलियम आर आसाम एंड गुजरात. ओके, हेवी फ्यूल ऑयल और क्रूड ऑयल इज इम्पोर्टेड एंड देन रिफाइंड एट डिफरेंट रिफाइनरीज. द रिफाइनरीज ऑफ अ क्रूड ऑयल सप्लाइज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रोडक्ट कॉल्ड पेट्रोल पेट्रोल कैन ऑल्सो बी मेड बाय पॉलीमराइजेशन ऑफ द रिफाइनरी गैसेस. अदर लिक्विड फ्यूल्स आर केरोसिन, फ्यूल ऑयल, कोलाइडल फ्यूल एंड अल्कोहल. यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट द ONGCs. द ONGCs टेकन टेक और ऑप्टेन क्रूड ऑयल फ्रॉम द सी क्रस्ट, अर्थ क्रस्ट एंड दीज क्रूड ऑयल्स देन सप्लाइड टू द रिफाइनरीज. इन रिफाइनरी वी गेट अ डिफरेंट फॉर्म ऑफ ऑयल लाइक पेट्रोल, डीजल, केरोसिन एंड ऑल अदर फॉर्म ऑफ फ्यूल. नाउ गैसेस फ्यूल. नेचुरल गैस. द मेन कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ नेचुरल गैस आर मिथेन दैट इज CH4 एंड इथेन दैट इज C2H6. इट हैज कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू नियरली 21,000 किलोजूल पर मीटर क्यूब. नेचुरल गैस इज यूज अल्टरनेटली और साइमल्टेनियसली विथ ऑयल और फॉर इंटरनल कंबशन इंजिन. नेचुरल गैस कैन बी यूज फॉर इंटरनल कंबशन इंजिन अलॉन्ग विथ लिक्विड गैसेस, लिक्विड फ्यूल्स. नाउ कोल गैस. कोल गैस मीन्स गैसेस ऑब्टेन बाय द बर्निंग ऑफ कोल. मेनली कंसिस्ट ऑफ हाइड्रोजन कार्बन मोनॉक्साइड एंड हाइड्रोकार्बन. इट इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय कार्बोनाइजेशन ऑफ कोल. इफ इट फाइंड्स इट्स यूज इन बॉयलर एंड समटाइम्स यूज फॉर कमर्शियल पर्पजेस. ओके, द गैस इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द कोल बाय द कार्बोनाइजेशन प्रोसेस कॉल्ड एज अ कोल गैस. कोक ओवन गैस. इट इज ऑब्टेन ड्यूरिंग द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कोक बाय हीटिंग द बिटुमिनस कोल. When the bituminous coal is being heated, the gas obtained is called as a coke oven gas. The volatile content of a coal is driven off by heating and major portion of this gas is utilized in heating the ovens. Okay, in oven bituminous coal is used. By the heating of bituminous coal, the gas obtained is called as a coke oven gas. Since it is used in the oven, it is called as a coke oven gas. The gas must be thoroughly filtered before using in a gas engine. This gas, coke oven gas, can be used in a gas engine, but before using it should be filtered, it should be cleared. Now blast furnace gas. The gas obtained from the blast furnace is called a blast furnace gas. It is obtained from smelting operation in which air is forced through layers of coke and iron ore. The example being that of the pig iron manufacture where this gas is produced as by the product and contains about 20% carbon monoxide. After filtering it may be blended with richer gas or used in a gas engine directly. The heating value of this gas is very low. The gas obtained from the blast furnace is used for gas engines, but calorific value is very less. It contains about 20% of carbon monoxide. And after filtering, we can use for the gas engines. Producer gas. It results from the partial oxidation of the coal, coke or peat when they are burnt with an insufficient quantity of air. When the coal, coke or peat is burnt in insufficient quantity of air, it produces the producer gas. It is produced in specially designed retorts. It has a low heating value and in general it's suitable for large installation. It is also used in steel industry for firing open hearth furnace. Water or illuminating gas. It is produced by blowing steam into white hot coke or coal. When the steam is blown in the coke or coal, then we get a gas, and that gas is called as a water or illuminating gas, and it contains large amount of moisture. The decomposition of a steam takes place, liberating free hydrogen and oxygen. In the steam combines with carbon to form carbon monoxide accordingly the reaction. When the carbon is blown by steam, that is H2O, steam is a water vapor, then carbon react with H2O and form carbon monoxide and release hydrogen. The gas composition varies as the hydrogen content if the coal is used. The gas composition varies as the hydrogen content if the coal is used. Sewer gas. Sewer gas is obtained from the sewer material, that is sewer lines. It is obtained from sewage disposal in which fermentation and decay occurs. Decay means degradation. It consists of mainly marsh gas, that is methane gas. Methane gas is also called as marsh gas, CH4, and is collected at a large disposal plant. It works as a fuel for gas engine, which in turn drives the plant pump and agitators. Now the advantages of advantages of gases fuel: better control of combustion. We can control the supply of gas fuel. Much less excess air is needed for complete combustion. Economy in fuel and more efficiency of the furnace operation. Easy maintenance of oxidizing or reducing atmosphere. Cleanliness. No problem of storage if the supply is available from public supply line. The distribution of gaseous fuel even over a wide area is easy through the pipeline, and as such handling of the fuel is altogether eliminated. In India, most of the places we use gas by the gas lines. Okay, therefore there is no problem of storing it in a cylinder. Therefore we can use gas directly from the gas lines. Gaseous fuels gives economy of heat and produces higher temperature. It can be preheated in regenerative furnace, and thus heat from hot flue gases can be recovered. Gaseous fuels gives economy of heat and produces higher temperature. Okay, since the calorific value is high, it can produce very high temperature, and there is no storage problem, and it does not contain any ash. Therefore it is very economical. Now basic chemistry we'll see in the next class.